Okay, here we are again. This is exciting. I don't know how you live your life and what you've been looking forward to, but I for one, have been looking forward to this. Get past some of these introductory videos. We're here. I feel a little more comfortable. Hopefully you feel a little more comfortable. We are getting ready to talk about this, the building block of all of the examples that we're going to look through it up through this entire video series. We're going to look at physics simulation, steering behaviors, fractals, genetic algorithms, all sorts of stuff. We need something to start with. And the topic that is sort of the foundation for everything we're going to build on is vectors. So I want this video to really just answer two single questions, a pair of questions, if you will. What is a vector? And the second question really is, why do we even care? Why, if we are people who live our lives walking around and sitting down and doing stuff and eating food and then sometimes getting at a computer and programming graphics, why should we care about a vector? So the first question, what is a vector? I'm supposed to answer that question. Okay, so this is not the easiest question to answer. First of all, it has a lot of, it's hard, it's complicated. But you know, let's simplify it for ourselves. Let's talk about a vector in two-dimensional space for a moment. I know that we don't live in two-dimensional space, but we program a lot in two-dimensional space, and we also have a two-dimensional space. This is kind of a two-dimensional space right here. I'm doing weird things to the whiteboard. Hello. I just forgot to start the timer, so I don't know how long I've been going, but it's been a minute, but we're going to get to this question. I feel awkward about it because I don't want to give the wrong answer. Let's try. Together. What is a vector? Okay, let's draw a vector for a second. We can represent a vector in two-dimensional space as an arrow. We could actually represent it in three-dimensional space as an arrow as well, but let's look at this. This is our vector. Let's think about this more with a little more substance and detail. A vector is something that has magnitude. That's a key concept here. And two, direction. With an exclamation point to emphasize that point. A vector has both magnitude and direction. Now, looking at this arrow, I think this stuff might be somewhere. I think you might have figured this out already. What is the magnitude? What is the magnitude of this vector? The magnitude of this vector, we can say, is the length of it, or the size. This is the magnitude of a vector. Is it a long arrow? Is it a short arrow? What is the direction? Also, perhaps, a somewhat obvious question. The direction of this vector is the direction that it's pointing in. Right? An arrow points in a particular direction. We could formalize that, right? We sort of formalize magnitude by saying the length, like I could get out a ruler and measure it, and that's actually the magnitude of that vector. We could say perhaps the direction is perhaps an angle relative to some axis. Like if we think of having an x-axis, a horizontal axis, a line here, the direction could be represented by an angle. And I'm going to use the Greek letter theta. Somebody's knocking at the door. I thought this would happen eventually. Okay, we cut scene back and we're back. Sorry for the little interruption there. So let's think about vectors for a moment in a slightly different way. Let's say you're giving directions to somebody from how to get from point A to point B. You might say, look, you're looking to leave this place that you're in and run away and escape. It's not very far, the door. Take five steps forward, or let's say four steps forward because it's not that far. One, two, three, four, turn 90 degrees to the right and take three steps. Goodbye. One, two, three. Well, I could draw that out on the board as one, two, three, four steps, turn to the right, and one, two, three. Now, if we look at this, I started in point A and I ended up in point B, and here is my vector. This arrow describes how I get from point A to point B, and this is on, and I keep looking at it. I gotta turn it off, because I would like to look at you. This is just us here, this strange, I don't know, place that we are. Okay, so this vector has four steps over here and three steps over here. It turns out, by the way, what does this look like to you? It looks like a right triangle with a right angle. You might remember this thing called the Pythagorean Theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, the 3, 4, 5 triangle. The length of this arrow is actually 5. We're starting to see something here. even though a vector conceptually is just this idea of an arrow, it has a length and it has a way that it's pointing, the magnitude and the direction, we also start to see here, there seems to be some type of math related to this that has to do with things we learned in geometry and trigonometry, and we can make an angle here. We start saying sine of the angle is opposite over hypotenuse, and cosine is, well, adjacent over hypotenuse. Hopefully I got that right. What's going on here? Well, a vector can actually be separated into its components, the x component and the y component. We can see that over here. Here is the x component, that length, and this length here is the y component. So even though a vector is expressed as an arrow, length and magnitude, it can also be expressed as a pair of numbers, an x and a y. Now, you might be, that might sound familiar to you, right? When was the last time you wrote a processing sketch where you didn't just stick at the very top of your program, float x, float y? And this is the moment where we have now answered our second question. Why do we care about vectors? Because we do this all the time. We have x and y for position. We have x speed and y speed for velocity. Maybe we have x acceleration, y acceleration, x wind, y wind, x friction, y friction, x blast, y blast. I don't know, you could come up with any variable. It's x, y, this, and then when you go into 3D, you're x, y, and z, and x speed, and y speed, and z speed. You're just this pile and pile of variables that you can't get control over, and you're doing the same stuff with them over and over again. A simple thing you do with them over and over again is x equals x plus x speed, y equals y plus y speed. Right? But then when y speed changes by gravity and then x speed changes by wind, you just have all of this stuff happening over and over again. And there might be, there's lots of mathematical functions. This is, I've just said this three times. This is why we might, this is why if we can, this is like very almost like primal level, the very first way of understanding why we care about vectors is just to say, I don't want to have this in my code. I want to say instead of float xy, I want to say p vector position. Now, P vector is a class in processing that makes an object which is a vector. And we're going to get into the, I think this video, it just needs to end and we'll move on to the next one. You can just watch them continuously. But in the next video, we're going to get into the code more, more deeply. So let's actually just, though, before we go to the next video, walk over here to this blank space because this computer went to sleep. Whoa, magic. Okay, so look at this. This is the pristine example of exactly what I'm talking about. We have a processing sketch where this ball moving around the screen. Oh, come on. Seriously, computer? Well, you can imagine. Look, I'm the ball bouncing around the screen. This is so sad. This whole, there we go. Okay, where this processing sketch has an x and a y for position and an x speed and a y speed for essentially what we're going to start calling velocity, the velocity vector of this object, of this shape that's moving around the screen. So what I would like to do for give you as an exercise before you move on to the next video is go and find a processing sketch. It's like a skit and a sketch. Can you make a processing skit, like program a skit? That would be kind of interesting. Would it be entertaining to watch? I don't know. Find a sketch that you've made that where you model motion somewhere, where you have x's and y's and x speeds and y speeds, go and find that sketch. Because in the next video, we're going to look at how we actually, instead of just having x and y everywhere, how we start using the p vector class to describe the position of an object and the way that position changes over time. So that's what we're going to do in the next sketch. I'm going to walk through this particular example. Then if you'll have found yours, then you'll try to add p vector into your sketch, and then hopefully we will figure out some way that we could communicate to each other, and you could ask me some questions and I could answer some questions, because you are not a person. You are just this strange lens staring at me in this creepy, strange way. I must stop this video now. Okay, so I think this is good for now. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it if you're still watching. I'm kind of shocked and amazed, actually, but hopefully you're learning something. If you're not, you could just email me a complaint. That would be fine. I will accept all complaints. Okay, there's a button I have to press over here to stop it. Okay, goodbye.